Hello everyone, today we will be looking at the Sonoff Zigbee 3.0 USB Dongle Plus. This is a USB dongle which is pretty much a gateway if you want to run Zigbee smart devices onto open source ecosystem like Home Assistant. I'm running Home Assistant and I have a couple Zigbee devices that I want to connect to. So this is why I got this guy. Also, I believe this use Thread protocol to connect Matter devices as well, which is a plus since Matter is getting really popular. So this little guy should be able to connect my Zigbee and Matter devices. So this is pretty much a dongle. Sonoff actually makes two versions that looks the same. So this version I have is the Zigbee dongle -P, as you can see here, but they also have a dash E version. The difference between the two is different chipsets. I decided to go with the P, which is an older chipset that I believe is made by Texas Instrument, and the version 2 I believe is made by Silicon Labs. Here's a chart of the difference between the two. I'll put it up on the screen right now, and as you can see on this chart, this is the difference. Both work well, and I believe both work with Zigbee and Thread. So I think both of them are out right now, so you can't go wrong with both. I think the -P is the -P has been out longer, so it's more used, more stable, rock solid. I believe the -E is pretty good too. I actually have a Sky Connect on another Home Assistant instance that I use, and that uses the Silicon Labs one, and that one works pretty good, and I had no problem with it. So I just wanted to try the I'm deploying another Home Assistant, and I wanted to give this one a try. So yeah, so that's the difference, as you can see on the screen here. But this is the -P, so let's go ahead and open it. I'm gonna unbox it. It's gonna be a quick unboxing, so I'll unbox it. We'll set it up on my Home Assistant server, and then we'll see how we can connect the devices on there. So this is very small, as you can see. It's a small box, just blue retail packaging, very simple looking, nothing too fancy or anything. And inside the box, you get an antenna here, as you can see, and it screws on right here at the end, and it could pretty much bend up too. And you have the actual dongle here. This dongle is made out of aluminum, so there's an aluminum housing here. Probably helps for heat dissipation and protect from any interference. And you got your USB-A connector here, and this is where you would connect the antenna on the back. So you just pretty much just screw it on like that and just plug this into the USB slot onto your computer, and Home Assistant should see it, and you should be able to run your devices. The firmware and everything is already flashed by Sonoff on here, so you should be good to go here. It should be pretty much plug and play. If you want to get better signal, they recommend getting a USB cable extender, so that the farther away this is, I guess, from the computer, the better signal you have. So that's optional, but with this antenna, this should help. So yeah, that's the unboxing part of it. So let's get it installed onto the computer, and then we'll see what Home Assistant see as we plug it in. All right, so after you install the USB dongle onto your Home Assistant server with one of your USB port, just go back to your Home Assistant here, and then basically what you want to do is go to settings, go to devices and services, hit add integration, and then look for Zigbee, and I'm going to do the Zigbee home automation right here, and then it's going to give you a couple of options. If you, as you can see, the second option here, the Sonoff Zigbee 3.0, that's the device that I plugged in. If you don't see it on here, you might have to reboot your Home Assistant to see it, and it will probably pop up on here. But for me, it looks like it popped up here already. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the Sonoff Zigbee 3.0, and then I'm going to hit submit. And then basically it's going to set up my Sonoff Zigbee dongle as a Zigbee gateway for my home assistant. So let's wait for it to finish its install and network formation. So we're going to pretty much create a new network. So I'm going to create a new network. So after it was setting up, I did have some Zigbee devices already on my network, and I've unpaired it to use this new Sonoff one, and it actually picked up all the devices, as you can see, on my network, which I was pretty surprised. I thought it would have to pair each one, I thought I would have to pair each one again, but it looks like it just picked it all up, which is pretty cool. So this is all the Zigbee devices that I have on my current home assistant network right now. And it picked it all up, which is pretty cool. So I'm going to go ahead and just set some of the areas here. This is the chipset. So I'm going to put this in computer closet. And let's see, Silicon Labs. I believe I'm going to leave this one alone. This is probably my Sky Connect, which is I'm using for Matter. I'm not using multi-protocol because there's some issues with it. This is my presence sensor. I believe these are all the leak sensors. So you know what, I might have to go back and fix these later, but for now I'm just gonna hit finish. And if I scroll down, I see 10 devices. So yeah, looks like these four here, I know that they're my water sensor. This one here, I believe, is my door sensor. And I think this one here might be my window sensor. So it looks like it picked everything up. I was pretty surprised. I thought I had to repair everything. So that was pretty cool. But If you ever need to repair your device, just search for it online, and you can pretty much hit the reset button. They'll show you how to reset the device so you can repair with your network. So yeah, so I just need to pretty much identify where these devices are. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. That's pretty much a quick setup of a quick unboxing of the Sonos dongle. Installing it on Home Assistant and having it able to pick up all of my current Zigbee devices on the network. So that's pretty much it. That's the video. As you can see, it's pretty straightforward, painless, really easy to install, easy to use. So if you have any questions or comments, go ahead and leave it down below. I'm gonna go ahead and end the video here since it's just unboxing and quick setup. If you, yeah, just comment if you have any questions. I'll try to answer my best. And like always, thank you for watching. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace out till next time.